And we made it to the coast. So this is like North Beach campground. So campground is full, even for me. Anyway, let's have a look. It is Sunday, maybe some people left. I don't know how we're supposed to book it. It's only $10 apparently, but I we'll ask.
Is it my lucky day?
Day 32. I got one spot left.
Yes, thank you so much.
How many nights?
Just one.
Cool.
Thank you.
What do you do for YouTube?
Right, okay, very professional. We got this.
Beautiful.
That's it. And which site am I going to?
Site 32. I'm just trying to find a paperwork for this.
Huh? 32, 32. We are all set. Unfortunately, it's getting really, really chilly, but hey, we need to see the ocean before it gets dark. So let's go to the beach. Just trying to remember when the last time I've seen an open ocean. I think in Canada. Well, in Texas, I saw the Gulf of Mexico, but that was not open ocean. Oh, wow. I can see it now. It's very, very pretty. Go up and down, but we're getting there, we're getting closer. So it's like we're on the dunes now. Wow, is there a path? I'm not sure. I don't know.
That looks like this is the beach access. What could possibly go wrong?
First obstacle. Oh. This is how it looks like. My shoes are full of sand. That's okay. Yes, we can go either through the structure, right? Or we can just go there. Ah, what the hell, let's go through the structure. Balance, Kinga, balance. All right, here we go. Are we holding camera and having this? Ooh, wobbly. Timber, timber, wood, timber. And we're on the other side. Let's say hi to the Pacific Ocean. I'm not sure how to go back because it's just dunes, 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 dunes everywhere. I think. Is that the only way to go with? Get out? It's like I have to climb the dunes? I don't know. Okay, and maybe I think here is a little bit lower. How's that? I think so. This is where we're gonna go. Although it, I don't think I can do it with a camera in my hand. Maybe here? Yeah, here is good. Look at this. Look at this. Beach access. Very good. Very. Too easy. Right, I'll set you up. Okay, let's go. This is a piece of cake. And we are at the top. This is such a cool beach, I love it. Okay, so we made it to LA. Look at this highway. It's got like six lanes. One way. So far we're lucky with the traffic, but not for too long. I reckon we're gonna hit the traffic very soon. LA is very famous for its traffic. It's just insane. So I'm here only for a couple of days, just to see a few people and collect some stuff that was shipped to me. Next week, for literally a few days, I have to be in Mojave Desert for the Rivzilla event, so I'm only like in and out of LA. Yep, and what did I tell you? Traffic. But the good thing is, in California, lane filtering, like, you know, going between the cars, it's legal. But I won't record it, just in case. Alright, so, the first person I'm gonna visit here in LA is, you'll never guess. Well, his name is Jimmy Hanks, and he's the brother of Tom Hanks, and he's also an actor, and he lives not too far. We've got 2 miles to his house, so we're gonna go there and say good day. All right, we're nearly here. So Jimmy said he's gonna open a gate for me. That's us. Hey! Thank you. Where would you like me to? On the left, to the left or to the right?
No, you're right.
Here is fine. Hello. Good, thanks. How are you going? Oh my God, the traffic, right?
Jimmy, how's my hair?
It's always the same. Oh,
I can see the same thing about you, you know?
That's absolutely true.
So, this is Jimmy Hanks, the first person I'm visiting here in LA. Jimmy and I, we have mutual friends, and I've heard so much about him, so I just had to say, pop in and say hi. So, Jimmy is Tom Hanks' brother. You do. There is a similarity. I can tell. You've got the same genes, mate.
We share parents. So
that's right. That's right. Jimmy, so, above all, you're an adventure rider.
Mm-hmm.
And when did you start your journey with adventure and riding motorcycles? How long have you been riding?
I was working for Disney, and I would go into the Disney parking structure, and I always saw these motorcycle parking spots right when you came in. I went, that'd be cool, because they always made you park up on the roof and have to walk all the way down. So the first motorcycle I got was, graduating from a scooter, I got a Honda PC 800, and it was a good first bike.
Yeah,
it was underpowered, but you know, it got me around. And I started doing some trips. Went out to Death Valley, and the first time I'd ever been to Death Valley was on that bike. Then I had that bike for a couple of years, outgrew it, got a V-Strom 1000, and drove that all over the place. And then I got invited to do the Idaho BDR. Didn't want to take the V-Strom, but a friend of mine had a bike like yours, the 800GS, and he'd ridden around the world. And that's Mark Dunham, or known as Radio Man for people who follow that stuff. And so I used his bike, and first time I'd ever done anything off-road, and I was like,
oh. 800GS.
The other three guys were all on 1200s.
But you know, if you've never done it, it's a big bike to just to start.
Yeah.
But you've done it. You survived.
Yeah, I mean, I think I was on... We were doing the first part of the Idaho BDR, and I think I was about 4 or 5 hours into it, And okay. I said to the other guys on the,
that's it.
We had the Senna's and said, all right, that's it. And they went, what? When I get home, I'm selling my bike and getting a bike like this.
But you didn't get a bike like this. What do you have now at the moment?
I have the Honda Africa Twin, the 18, which is the 1000. I absolutely love it.
I divide ADV riders into two categories. Travelers like myself, mm-hmm. or people who are just really great riders who push their boundaries and, you know, you do short trips and then just to beat up the bikes and come mm-hmm. back home. In which category you are, you think?
Oh, I'm definitely a traveler.
A traveler, yeah. Okay.
That's still, as much as I like doing the off-road stuff, I'm still really intimidated by it.
Yeah.
And I know at some point I'll get a little more training.
Traveling is always good.
Yeah.
But you do enjoy traveling on a bike and experience
it. Yeah.
And you take off for a long time. Like you take off at one month at a time, right?
Yeah. Usually in the summer, I've taken a lot of trips with Mark and we've done like a month. Just being on the road. I think the last trip we did was about 5,000 miles or something.
It's crazy. So this is your passion. We're on the same page here. But in your professional life, you're an actor.
Mm-hmm.
For like, so when did you decide to be an actor?
I fell into it in my late 20s when my wife and I moved to LA. She was an actor, and really wanted to go somewhere where she could, you know, I want to go somewhere where I can make a living at it.
Sure.
And so we decided to come down here, and I got sucked into it very quickly after that. I wasn't an actor before then. Her first boss was an agent and said, oh, you're related to, okay. You should try this. And so got me into some auditions that I was horribly unqualified to be at. And so I ended up getting into class, and my first class I did a scene and went, oh, I get it. And I was hooked from that point on. I don't do much in front of the camera mm-hmm. anymore, or ever really, because of this. You know, I've never been a face in the crowd. You know, I can't be, you know, second guy from the left, because everybody goes, wait a second. Okay, looks like, where is it? And then I start talking, and where is it? And I've ended up doing a lot of voiceover.
And do you enjoy that?
I love it. And it's great, because you don't have to memorize anything. It's right there.
Right.
And then I've also gotten into writing. Right. I've got a few things that, fingers crossed, are about to happen. So we'll see.
Oh. Which year is this?
This is an 18.
18.
The 30th anniversary.
Right.
I think it's the prettiest of them.
Yes. No, I really love that color. I think that's the best color they've ever done.
And it's a DCT, which actually I really like.
Which is what? What's that DCT? What does it mean?
What's that? It's a dual clutch. It doesn't have the normal clutch.
Oh, you don't have a clutch. That's the one without the clutch?
Yeah.
That's so cool. Apparently, it's a good system, and you would.
Yeah.
It's faster than shifting, right?
Yeah, you know, that doesn't bother me. It's just like, especially around here when you're splitting lanes to not have to worry about what gear you're in. You can just concentrate on that.
And look at this. Now you have a matching kangaroo.
I didn't realize.
I gave you one with the one with the blue jumper. How pretty, right? You can ride it now. Look at that.
Color coordinated.
Right? All right, Jimmy.
All right.
So long, my friend.
So great to meet you.
You too. Bye.
Bye.
Day two in LA. And here, this time, I'm hosted by Tim. Tim, actually, Leah Rick put us in touch because Tim met Leah when she was on her round the world trip like 8 years ago, long time.
Yeah.
You guys met in
Uzbekistan.
So
randomly.
Right?
Yeah.
But Tim's got such a great garage, so guys, you have to see it. So you have to hear his story. So Tim, in which year did you do your round the world trip?
2016.
And what was your route at the time?
So we started in China. Tianjin, China. We went up through Inner Mongolia, up to Mongolia, up through Siberia, like the Altai region of Russia,
sure.
and into Kazakhstan and all through the stands. We didn't do Tajikistan, damn it, you
yes,
know?
Yes, I know. That's,
we have to go back
yeah,
for that.
You need to leave something for later.
And then we meandered, you know, through Europe, basically, through the Adriatic side of, through the Baltic side of the Adriatic.
And how long was that trip?
So we spent about 4.5 months on that trip.
You went quick.
It was kind of a shotgun.
Yes.
You know.
And you did it on which bike?
So I did it on this KLR over here. So I did it on the KLR 650, which is, as you round the worlders know, is the bulletproof bike, you know, to do that type of thing on. It's it's not fancy. It's not even thrilling, you know, but it gets the job done. It gets the job done. It's like a Jeep. You
right.
Know?
And since then, well, since then, or like additionally, you have plenty of other bikes in the garage.
Yeah.
So what have you got there?
So this is just, that's my first bike that I ever had right there. So that has a special place in the garage.
Yes.
This is just an oddball Buell Lightning, just a hooligan bike. And really a great bike.
Yeah.
And one of a kind. Those Buell bikes are one of a kind. And then this is my track bike, which is a Triumph Speed Triple 1050.
And this is the newest one.
And
you
then
have.
This is the newest one that I bought in 2020. And it's I bought it and immediately did the Trans-American Trail on it. And it's a KTM, so we had problems, you know. But it is an awesome bike, and all of the problems have been hopefully sorted, and we're getting ready to do multiple adventures on it.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome, you're welcome.
For having me, and hopefully next time we'll be somewhere on the road.
That would be awesome if we could do that. Yeah,
totally.
I would love that. Yeah,
we're going to do that.
It'd be lovely to get Leah, too, involved. Yeah.
Rick.
We need to get her back on her bike.
Thank you for putting us in touch. Yeah, that's right.
This was a very short visit in LA. But you know what? I really don't count it like I was even here. This is Hollywood Boulevard. Okay, so this is what I meant to say. Before I leave, we have to see this street. Look at this. These epic palm trees. Wow, this is so cool. Right, so I will be back to LA in a few months once I'm done Alaska and all the other states. And this will be my like last final destination. Before I enter Mexico, so I will spend here a little bit more time because I know there's like so much riding here. There's heaps of good riding here, and I'll be definitely back for longer. Meanwhile, I have to rush up because I have two events happening, so I've got a lot of commitments in coming months. But like, yeah, just let's enjoy Hollywood because this is Hollywood. Apparently. Well, Hollywood Boulevard, yes. And you are. The famous palm trees. So cool. Okay, let's keep going through the boulevard, but I think the street will be blocked soon. This is cool, right?
Proudly displaying it.
Yes.
There we go.
It's happening.
That's worth at least, what, 25 miles per hour more?
At least.
Yeah.
At least.
I think so.
There you go. So, OHV approved.
So fast now.